prophet. I only believe in Allah. And I don't believe in Hadith. There are some Muslims. They call them Quraniyun. They don't believe in all these saying of the prophet. They believe in the Quran. Anything outside Quran, forget. Because we have freedom of religion. You cannot tell me I should believe in prophet. You can't take me to court. That is the issue. So as far as Islamic world is concerned, Shaykh is a nuisance. And is constituting nuisance to Muslim world.
Okay. Now, one question that easily comes to the mind of Nigerians is that why can't we re-educate or reorientate this so-called misguided Shiite so that they don't rubbish Islam and of course the tenets of Islam?
I think the problem is there is hypocrisy in Nigeria. When anybody sees any group, you will not, and if the group is a threat, you want to make benefits, take advantage of the group. Let me give you an example. In Vanguard, there was Nasir El-Rufai, governor of Kaduna State, became governor. He visited Zekseki and he solicited for his support and went before the election. And you see, according to, let me just, he said there was an official. He claimed to have witnessed the visit, but as that his name not be mentioned for his security, since the Shaykh have been proscribed in Kaduna, record that. So he said there was a meeting between El-Rufai and Zekseki. And El-Rufai solicited for the support of Islamic movement in Nigeria. And according to the report, the Shaykh said, they have never participated in politics because they don't believe in democracy. But they said they will participate in politics because of El-Rufai and Muhammadu Buhari, hoping that when after they emerge, they can continue and then perhaps in their own thinking. I don't see how a same person can think that he can Islamize Nigeria, that you can use El-Rufai and then Muhammadu Buhari to Islamize Nigeria. So after El-Rufai now emerge, I don't know the terms. That was the now started displaying their own power. They thought El-Rufai will contain them. God, he has come to solicit for their support in politics. So I think the government or the people who are in power or people who want to be in power should not be desperate. El-Rufai will not tell us that he has not read about this group. He went to solicit for their support. And after he became the governor, these people now became more wide. And initially they have been doing it. Ramalan Yaro has been containing them, cautioning them. You just hear about their clash, but not as worse as it is now. But when El-Rufai emerged, they saw it as one of us. So they believe they could do anything and without being challenged. And unfortunately for El-Rufai, because the panel of inquiry he set up, the panel of inquiry in his report cautioned Nigerian army and he condemned the hack that though this group was too violent and was too dangerous, but that did not give Nigerian army that authority to kill them. He said, though this group is too violent, but there should be an alternative means to check them. You cannot just kill them because, like in that operation, Zekseki lost 6 children, and those children, they were 2 of them were final year. They were not schooling here. That's another thing. They were educated. This issue of shite is not the issue of they are not. Well, that's why Iran, Iraq, Syria, the Americans still believe that they have all these nuclear weapons. They build engineers, they train them, they are genius. Zekseki is not a nuisance. For somebody to have a first class in economics, they poach him. As soon as they discover him, they took him away to Iraq. They train him, they sponsor him, they gave him money, they sent him back to Nigeria. Where are the intelligence of this country? They ought to have at least bust this move that somebody has returned to Nigeria. It was a secretary general of Muslim Student Society of Nigeria when he was at Madubolo University as a student, as an undergraduate. Later, he became vice president of MSSN, national vice president. So he rose to that level, but they saw him. What Nigerian government did not see in him, other people in other countries saw him, and then they took him away. They trained, they gave him isolated training. They sent him back, and they pumped enough of money. That's why you see them, they will celebrate. Anytime they celebrate any festival, there must be blood.
Okay, now, Daoud, before we go to the implications of the clash that led to the death of El Zakzaki's children and the continued incarceration of El Zakzaki himself, let me quickly ask you, are you saying that this movement of the Shiites are beyond redemption, reorientation, and education? That the only thing the government can do now is to use force to curtail their excesses?
Just like the former president would say, you have to use carrot and whip and carrot. There are some of them that they wanted to die. They want to die. That you can't rehabilitate them. Because this is a doctrine. They have been indoctrinated. And we call it radicalization of youth. They have radicalized their thinking. They are looking at paradise according to them. And they want to die. But there are some of them that are doing it ignorantly. If government can use a contract these enlightened Muslim leaders, they can do it. But it will take time because the government is supposed to have prevented it. It has happened. But we should not fool ourselves and say they are in Kano, they are everywhere, even they are in Ogun State. But you won't feel them because they have not got to the level to strike. Because we, as a Muslim, we have some of them that we just feel like, this is not right. If you say you are a Muslim, you must do what is in the Quran and Hadith. So all these things they are doing is not in the Quran.
So they are in Ogun State?
They are. The six security people cannot say they are not there. But the problem is, it's not that you can't know them through their appearance at all. You know them through when they display their, for example, if they will not say Allah Akbar, they will say Ali Akbar. There are some things that they will do, you know they are shy. They don't hide it. God, they have been indoctrinated. They don't hide it.
Before we go on this break, if I got you correctly, you said other than killing them, there should be ways of checkmating these people.
Yeah.
Other than going ahead to kill them.
Yeah.
Are you supporting that they should remain in the state?
No,
hold on.
I don't understand what.
Okay, I'll put that through when we come back, right after the national news.
Okay, for the national news, stay with us, we'll be back. The former Amir of the MSSN, that is the Muslim Student Society of Nigeria, Ebba Area Council, is also a journalist, a colleague in the media profession. And we are both looking at the issue of Shiites in Nigeria, the Islamic movement of Nigeria, with the head Sheikh El Zakzaki, who has been in incarceration for more than a year now.
Yes, 2015,
more than a year, ever since the clash with the Nigerian army, which led to bloodshed. Just on Monday, they had another clash with the Nigerian police force, leading to the death of over a dozen of them, and of course, a police officer. Now, before we go to that break, I want to first find out from you, would you say that the only way forward in curtailing the excesses of these people is the use of force? You try to talk about the carrot and stick approach that is usually proposed by the former president Olusegun Obasanjo. Many people will say, did that really work for us when we were trying to curtail the excesses of the Boko Haram sect? Now we have a dangerous situation in our hands. Should we continue to use carrot and stick?
Yeah, you see, when they use a stick against Boko Haram, it escalated. It worsened the situation. And you see, the 21 Chibok girls that were released, if not for the fact that federal government engaged them in dialogue, they would not have released them. So you cannot, they are Nigerians, you should know. So they are Nigerians. Only that they have dangerous belief, and we should treat them as Nigerians. It's not that they've been killing. Childs have not been killing. They are constituting nuisance. They are threats to the country. And as I've said it, because even we Muslims, we see them as nuisance. But we still regard them as, at least they are Muslims. But government has the machinery to solve this crisis. You see, I wanted to quote what happened between El-Rufai and then Ezekiel before he became governor. Please allow me to just, one of the persons that was inside, he said, "I was there when he came to visit Sheikh. We had debated among ourselves whether we should welcome him to the home of our leader. In the end, it was agreed that he could come since he was talking about justice and against abuse of power and failure of government at that time. Let me try to tell you what he said." He said, he was quoting El-Rufai now, "I wonder at your resilience. I respect your faith in the Almighty Allah. Here you are carrying on with life as if a great disaster has not happened to you. You lost your three sons, all of them studying very important courses abroad. They were killed by soldiers. One of them was even a final year student in a Chinese university, where he was a final year student in an aeronautical course. I've lost a son through a natural death, and for 3 months, I could not concentrate on anything. I could hardly eat. If I were you, I would have been so heartbroken that I would have had a stroke and died, or would have been bedridden and incapacitated. I feel moved by your courage. Please, excuse me, let me know if there is anything you want me to do for you when we come to power. We shall never tolerate such impunity. We shall respect the dignity of the human person and the right to life." For the first time, they are now talking. Our leader told us, that is, the guy was saying it, that for the first time, Ezekiel told them that we should stand with the CPC and Buhari as his leader. He said, "With people like El-Rufai, should Buhari become president, we shall get justice, and that Nigeria will be a better place for everyone." So as individuals, we went out, and I swear by the Almighty Allah, without a penny from the APC, we campaigned for Buhari and El-Rufai when they picked the ticket of their party. I run a private business. I almost closed it down using my resources and campaigning for change during the 2015 campaign. We deeply regret supporting them. They just use us. It was indeed with Ivoria that the IMN, Islamic Movement in Nigeria, came into the latest political dispensation after the APC won 2015 election. So, you see, if you look at this, you see the hypocritical tendency of these power mongers. El-Rufai would never tell us that he did not know this group is a threat. Ramalan Yero would not tell us that he has never read security report about them. What are we talking about? So they are Nigerians.
They fail to curtail it.
Because
they could be used.
Just like Boko Haram was used. I know you are following it. Yusuf was not violent.
Yes.
He was a graduate. But they killed them. They killed their leaders.
Now this is where it gets interesting, because it is this same cry for justice that the Islamic movement in Nigeria are crying out for, that the same Boko Haram elements were crying out for when Muhammad, Yusuf, and 9 other leaders were slain. El-Zak Zaki, from the last report that we heard, I don't know whether he's undergone the eye surgery that he so desperately needed when he was raided. But we understand that his health is also failing. He has lost 6 children.
Yes.
The trauma alone is enough to kill the man. Are we not finding ourselves in the same situation, dangerous situation we found ourselves in 2009, when Muhammad Yusuf and leaders of the Boko Haram sect were also killed. You are saying that the Shiite are not violent now. They are not killing now.
They in Kano are violent.
Okay.
But they are everywhere.
Okay. But right now, across, they are not killing.
Yes.
Now, the question is, do you foresee a situation where these people could translate into what Boko Haram became after the death of Muhammad Yusuf?
They are more dangerous than Boko Haram. You see, Boko Haram was known when they started bombing people. These Shiites, if you have been following there was no year. Anytime they wanted to celebrate any festival, they celebrate Ashura, that is a 10th date of Muharram. They celebrate Kudus, they celebrate birthday of Ali, birthday of Fatima, birthday of Muhammad. When they go, it is a law. They must come back with blood. So they are violent. And they don't, there are some issues. You see, when a principal of a school removed hijab of a sister in Abeokuta, in Ogun State, we Muslim students did not say, let's go and behead her. Because we said no. They reported her to the government. This woman has martyred a member. But if it had to happen there, a lot of lives will have lost.
Okay, so Dawood, what do you think? How do you think we can flush them out of our system?
We should not think of flushing them. I think strategic move should be made by arresting...
Are you supporting the group?
No. Because, is it the Nigerians?
Because that was almost my question.
No. I'm not supporting them.
You know where I'm going to.
Okay.
Are you supporting them? Then what do you think should be done? You said they are more deadly than Boko Haram. They are very dangerous. They are very violent. Don't you think the lives of Nigerians are at stake too? Having them around us. So what do you think they should be? That should be done?
What makes me to be thinking like this is because of the rendition I received. So the government should do more of imparting good orientation to them. You see, you can't throw a baby with the bath water. If you say, okay, let's flush them out. Since the army has been killing Boko Haram members, have they fully killed them? Because this is a doctrine. You cannot win. If as you are looking at me, because I have not been indoctrinated, so I reason according to the Quran. Because Quran never, in fact, Quran is found that whoever kills a soul would not enter paradise. So just a soul, let alone killing two people. What I'm saying is that government can look at using what, as I said, carrot and stick. There are some members that they are recalcitrant. But they should not kill them. I was saying that even the army that shot at them, that killed them, they have is it rubber bullet or whatever. They could have used it. And they will round them up, incarcerate them, deal with them. Even in that incarceration, they can enlighten them. Bring all these Islamic scholars. Yeah, show us we are in the Quran that you should do this. So they should not kill them. They can round them up. Take them to a special place. So yeah, tell us why you are doing this.
Well, how many of them do we even know? You said we have some of them right here in Ogun State. No, different states too.
Yes, but in Ogun State, there are not too many. So sometimes when we pray in the mosque, we just see one or two people displaying funny. But in time, we usually talk to ourselves.
Okay, if you have said this, don't you think it should start from you?
Yes.
If you have such people at the mosque, why didn't you begin to reorient?
We have started now. Thank God you are one of the audio mixer for one of our programs. No, that is one of the reasons why we brought that program to the media. Let's enlighten people. That's also, we are doing our own at our own local area. But we are saying that there are some Islamic scholars in this country whose voice are respected. Whose voice is respected. The government should contract them. There are some people.
To help
reorientate. Yes, there are some people. I can mention some names that if they just organize a program, do seminar in all the states, they should take it as a government project. They should not say that for Muslim. The Christians should not say they are pumping money into Islamic affairs. They should say it as attempt to orientate people. Contact some
and prevent
enlightened Islamic scholars. Professor Abik Abdulaziz is in Abuja. Abraham Sheikh Abraham Hamad. and any other people, they are very enlightened. Let them come, take them to East State, take them to some, there are some sports area, there are some volatile areas we know. The security cannot come to me and say, yeah, that will tell us. In their intelligence, they will know that in Abeokuta, they are some. In fact, there was a group that, but the group has, I don't know what happened to the group, it's no more prominent again. In fact, it got to a state that we were very, very afraid. They would say nobody should use toilet. He said that when you want to toilet, you must do it in the parlor, in your parlor. When you want to take your bath, it's around bathing in the bathroom. If you want to marry, you don't need any parental consent. If you have gone to study medicine, you are wasting your time. It's around. If you have gone to study law, it's a rubbish. Just go marry and then be in your husband's home. We try to fight them that this is enough. So if government can assist, government has the resources. But government should not give it to all these political jobbers who call them Muslims. So because we know what is so many things that are happening in all these IJ, pregames, all these Bodo. They should give it to the sincere and the enlightened people who will not look at the money government want to give them to enrich themselves. Who will do the real enlightenment?
But do we still have such people in Nigeria?
We do.
We do.
Yes.
Okay.
Even in the face of money.
We do. We do. Abba. We do. We do.
Okay.
At this juncture, we'd like to accommodate your own contributions, questions, opinions, as it were. Please make it very brief when you want to do so. That's especially when you call in. The number is to call at 0809-868-7344 and 0909-146-9670.
Or you may also use the short code dial 3